Great growth day, everybody. What's going on? Welcome to Doing Life with the Word. My name is Les.
Brother O.
And we are super excited because we're tapping into day two of how do I deal with my rebellious teen? Man, day one was special, bro.
Yeah.
Day one was special because we thought that, you know, when we talking about a rebellious teen, we thought it was going to be about the teenager.
Right.
But it was about us.
Right.
It was looking intrinsically, yeah. Right?
It was talking about. Fathers, don't provoke your kid to anger.
Absolutely. Yeah. So today we tapping into day two, which is sovereign control. And I'm super excited about this because we're going to tap into another level of this.
Yeah, of us getting hit with the bliggity.
Because we thought that it was going to be about them. Yeah,
it ain't about the kids. No, it's about guardianship. It's about who all dropped the ball.
Right.
Yeah, really.
Right. Who truly dropped the ball.
Yeah, really.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, look, real quick, we go to your Google Play Store, your App Store, and download the YouVersion Bible app. It is phenomenal. It's free. And it's a phenomenal way to tap in every single day with the word. And then also with your children, right? Your family. I like I say all the time, the search feature, right? It's like a Google. I can go in there and type in any situation, anything I'm dealing with, and I'll get a whole bunch of Bible plans, scriptures, and different things that will lead me to wise counsel. So it's just a pleasure. Just a pleasure to have the YouVersion Bible app. And, man. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for this opportunity to just tap in with you, Lord. I just ask that as we tap into your word, that someone is blessed by this word, that it permeates Lord. Their hearts and their minds, and that they look intrinsically, Lord, that they look at themselves, at every situation that they're dealing with, that they look at themselves, that they don't try to change anybody else around them, that they look to you, Lord. And that they examine themselves and that they see whatever is not like you, Lord, that they're able to change it, but not take the burden on for themselves, but they lean on you, right? Lord. They lean on you. They don't try to do it by themselves, that we don't try to do it by ourselves, but we do it together as a family in the body of Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. Sovereign control. We said yesterday that whenever parents are dealing with a rebellious child, they should examine their own lives. It is not so much about the rebellious teen as it is our responsibility to be pleasing to the Lord. Mm-hmm. The only negative command in the New Testament specifically to parents is do not exasperate your children. You may want to ask yourself, have I potentially contributed in any way to their rebellion? If there are any sins that the Lord point to in our lives, we should seek the Lord's forgiveness, and we should also seek our child's forgiveness. Mm. Wow. Beyond seeking forgiveness, we need to keep in mind God's sovereignty. You could raise your kids in the nurture and admonition of the Lord, but there is no guarantee that they're going to embrace Christ in their lives. Ouch. Many times the goal as Christian parents is that our kids become faithful followers of Christ. That should be every parent's desire, but that is not the ultimate goal. The bottom line is we're not in control of that. Ah, that hurts.
Too often we hold on that principle in the book of Proverbs that says, if you train your child in the way he should go, when he's old, he will not depart from it. So many times that verse is quoted by parents whose kids have veered away from the Lord or have never come to Christ and just rejected him. That verse is not necessarily true in that sense. It is more of a principle, and it may be, in fact, a bad interpretation of the original. In Hebrew, it could actually mean train up your child in his way. In other words, let him have his way all the time. And when he's old, he'll continue to want his way.
Wow. They should have put his in capital.
Yeah.
They should, yeah.
Right, because we know his way is the Lord's way. Yeah. That could be a better interpretation of that verse. Ultimately, our children are God's. I think we've created a culture in the church today that says good kids are the result of good parents, or godly parents equal godly kids. That is not a guarantee. Ultimately, God is sovereign over the hearts of our kids. It is good to make some self-examination. But once you've done that, and confessed and repented of any exasperating types of sins, don't beat yourself up. Trust the Lord that He has your kid's heart under His sovereign control.
Wow.
Man.
God is sovereign over the hearts of our kids. Wow. Parenting is so, you know, parenting, you could be so much of a control freak that you don't even incorporate in parenting with you repenting.
Wow.
A lot of times it's like, I'm the parent, I'm the dad, do this, I'm a dictator. But you don't even realize that you're operating wrong because you're the overseer, because you pay the bills and you cook or you go to the market, whatever you do, you don't even feel as though, you feel like you have an entitlement to be almost like a slave owner. You know what I mean? It's almost like master. You know?
Yeah, that's major, man. And that kind of entitlement will prevent you from seeking your child's forgiveness.
And that's
the damage. And that's,
and you don't even know that your kid is developing bitterness and anger and being emotionally unstable, you know?
Because you so caught up in your head.
Yeah.
You so caught up in, you know, this is my domain.
Right.
Right. And God never gave us dominion over people.
No.
Right? No. So one of the things that we have to recognize is that our children are people.
Yeah, they are.
Children are people.
Yeah.
And we got to treat them that way.
Now, don't get it twisted. You know, that cute stuff do get old. They do get annoying and you know, they do be clumsy and, you know, filthy and all that stuff where you have to exercise discipline. But in the same sense, that don't mean you have to go all the way in on them.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Oh, yeah. Well, it says train up a child in his way. Let him have his way.
Wow.
All the time. And when he's old, he'll continue to want his way.
Which exposes you as a parent. Because if you have to do it his way, that means you need to be in sync his way.
His way.
It should. What they say is it trickle down or it start from the top down. How they say?
Yeah, yeah.
Like we've been using the apple ain't fall far in the negative context.
Right.
You know what I mean? We need to
use
it in the
positive. Hey, you know. And you know what?
I've heard that so much. Yeah, the apple don't fall
far. The apple don't fall far.
You know what I mean?
But see, we...
Which is embracing generational curses.
Wow.
Really, it really is. Because this thing said, if there are any sins that the Lord points to in our lives,
meaning
He revealed it to you,
we
should seek the Lord in forgiveness, and we should also seek our child's forgiveness. We always hear about, for the most part, the parent-child relationship, which is a dictatorship.
Mm-hmm.
But we never really hear about the child-to-parent relationship. And I think that's what's missing. Like, I think what's missing is we don't give our kids a voice. Mm-hmm. I think we challenge them. And if they, and we so quick to say, don't talk back to me, where it's like, no, they're really God's creation too.
Mm-hmm.
And if they're a reflection of you, then why are you treating them and talking to them that way?
Mm-hmm.
Now, if there's some inadequacies in them and some immaturity, okay, you can check that. But in the same sense, don't miss it. Because if you miss it, you're stopping their emotional growth.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Like, I've been around your son.
Yeah.
He is hype. He is a hyper kid.
All the time.
But if you put a muzzle on him, you'll damage him.
Yeah, and
you'll really damage him.
And you know what, man? I've seen over the years, right, how he has developed and hasn't changed that because we've embraced it.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
There's times where he do the most, right? He does the most. And we definitely get with him about it,
mm-hmm.
because there's some things that he has to understand that was a little too much.
Right.
Right?
Right.
But to completely shut down who he is as a person.
Yeah, that's bad.
Right? That's terrible, man, because that's who he is.
Yeah, that's not covering. No, and I think, like, just, I wonder how many mothers owe their daughter an apology because they watch mom allow dad to get away with certain things and they never called dad on the carpet. They never took a stand.
Mm.
Now that daughter got older and she's struggling to submit to any man because she's afraid that all men are like their dad like her dad because mm-hmm. of what mom allowed. And she's afraid. Mm. She's fearful to tap in because she's like, wow, my mom ain't take a stand.
Wow.
So I wonder how many moms owe their daughter an apology. Like, it's and we ain't got to talk about fathers with sons.
Yeah,
because man. A son did this and a dad, like, you know, it's bad, man. Yeah. And I don't think parents associate apologizing to their kid. Like, mom, you didn't cover me. Dad, you didn't cover me. Dad, mm-hmm. you was wrong. Oh, shut up. And that ain't the answer.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Sovereign control. This thing said, if there are sins that the Lord point to our lives, we should seek the Lord's forgiveness. We should also seek our child's forgiveness. I wonder how many parents owe our kids an apology. Because they say we should seek our child's forgiveness, you know?
That's
and there's a lot of kids that's still grown and they still can't say nothing.
Yeah, and
you know what I mean?
Yeah. And
yet they treat the grandkids better than they treat their kids. And it's just like, yo, mom, you owe me a conversation.
Yo, that is so common.
Yeah.
That's so common, man.
Most kids don't even have a voice, even when they're adult. They can't say nothing to mom about that.
Yeah, they can't pull dad to,
you know?
Yeah, they're suffering in silence.
And what's crazy, you hope the Lord revealed to it, because you was telling me you had to build a little crib, and your dad told you when y'all had that conversation, he's like, son, I ain't even know. Yeah. Like, he wasn't even in tune.
Nah, he wasn't.
Sometimes we could just be on a whole nother track.
Yeah, man. And that's the thing. Like, sometimes we think we're over it too.
Right.
Until something comes up.
Mm-hmm.
And then it just reminds us of the things that we really been trying to run away from or keep silent. And keep secret, man. And that's another thing, you know, them secrets, man.
Yeah.
Those secrets is terrible. The enemy wants you to keep your mouth closed because he's trying to get you to think that if you tell them and you show them your scars, that they're going to judge you, right? But the reality of the matter is if you guide them through the process, I always say it's important to be transparent and not public about your mess.
Yeah.
Right? You know, we ain't airing dirty laundry.
We've
been strategic about how we're guiding the children.
Yeah, because that's the teaching part of Christianity where, like, when you have these parents that got kids that don't want to go to church, don't want to submit, it's like, look, let me tell you why I'm going to church.
Yeah.
This is what mom was into. This is what I used to do.
Yeah.
This is how I used to behave. This is how I used to think. Yeah. So when I'm not doing this because, like, you know, like, there's a reason why I'm doing this. Mm-hmm. When I say he is worthy, I mean that.
I wasn't worthy. Yeah.
So what you're doing, and I don't think the relationship is taught because we don't want to talk about why sins was cleaned up.
Right.
You know, but
nah.
You know what I mean? They don't want to talk like, yeah, you were a sinner.
Yeah.
We was already born a sinner, but I cashed in on some sins too. But I think that helps with this because it said, after God's sovereignty.
Yeah.
It say you can raise your kids in the nurture and admonition of the Lord, but there's no guarantee that they're going to embrace Christ in their lives. Mm-hmm. You know, this sentence hurts. This sentence hurts because it's not a guarantee.
Right.
You know, right. I want my offspring saved. Aubrey, Ava, Abraham, I want them, but it's really their choice.
It's really their choice.
And if they don't, if they're not interested in it, then I got to come to them. And I don't know heaven and hell thing, but like, look, this is how I'm so faithful to Miss Farron.
Yeah.
This is how I'm faithful to your mom. Like, you know, I got to tell you, what am I doing? Why am I giving? Like, this is keeping me on this. How I'm treating you is because of him.
Right.
You know, like, you don't want to obey. You don't want to submit to God. You don't want to read your word. But let me tell you what happened if you don't. Let me get grandmom on the phone. Let me tell you how you can be deceived.
Yeah.
Let me tell you how you can fall into a trap with no mercy and learn the hard way. You know?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, because.
Yeah.
And, you know, and it's lonely, though. It is lonely because, you know, even reading this, like, you can raise your kids in the nurture, and that don't mean they're going to do it. Like, at times when I was reading it, sometimes I feel like I'm just a independent contractor, you know, doing service for a king in his kingdom until I hear well done. Like, that, I can't even get my kids saved. Like, I'm just independent. Like, I ain't self-made. I'm in him. I'm connected with him. Mm. But what if I backslide? What if I say, Christ, I don't want... Like, what happened? Like, you know? Like, I... You know, it's just interesting how this is really... When I get to the gate, Farron, Aubrey, Ava, Abraham, like that, it's like, Alex, this is just me, you, and I.
Well, that's...
You know? Like,
that's why it says, you know, we got to do this thing by example.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, yeah, we could talk till we blue in the face, man. Yeah. But until they see us walk this walk, yeah, that we talking, it matters. It matters, yeah, not. You know what I mean? Nah, it matters not. So we really got to live this thing, man. We got to do life.
I've met more than a few parents that do have kids that don't serve and live for the Lord. And I'm not judging them. Mm-hmm. I just, their parents tell me of some of their actions and behaviors. And I don't think that those actions and behaviors are going to get them through the gate. You know, I'm not judging, but I always wonder, like, what's the disconnect? And I think it's this. I think we don't repent. Absolutely. I don't think we cover them. I don't think we keep it 100 with them. I think we just live and hold on to God unchanging hand, and we just hope, you know?
But keep it 100 with your kids.
Yeah, man. Show them your wounds.
Keep it 100 with your kids.
And Jesus, when he showed up, he said, yo, touch. You know, put your hand here. Like, yeah, look, I'm not running. This y'all saw what happened to me, but look, touch, you know.
Mm.
You know, we won't tell our kid nothing. Like, you know.
Wow.
Like, you need to apologize. Like, yeah, I'm sorry. You saw me do that to your mom. I'm sorry you hurt. Like, you know.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah.
Do it
in
the name of God.
Yeah.
Jesus of Nazareth.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. And that's why I love how it says, beyond seeking forgiveness, right, we need to keep in mind God's sovereignty.
Yeah.
We need to remind ourselves who God is.
Yes, we do.
Because sometimes we try to be God.
Yeah.
We try to be God, right? Or we try to put things in the place of God. And, you know, those things become the sources, right, of our attention and sources of everything that we believe is going to be the value that our kids are going to get.
Mm.
Right? Like, we might put them in a space, or we may put them in a program, and we think that that's God's gift. No,
that's not a good inheritance.
No, it's not, man.
No, we call inheritance leaving a legacy, like real estate, life insurance. Like, man. How about giving your kids a front row seat of consistency and love,
man,
and honor. And
patience,
and getting through and move, you know, that's what I want to hear at the funeral.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what I want to hear.
But
too. It blessed me that the last paragraph, ultimately our children are God's. That those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, those five words bless me tremendously, because I don't come from a Christian background.
Mm-hmm.
When I reflect over my family now, my mom's side of the family, my dad's side of the family, I don't have a cousin or an uncle where I can call and share scriptures with.
Mm-hmm.
I don't come from where, you know, I just have a host of, like, godly blood,
mm-hmm,
you know?
Mm-hmm.
My grandma was hard on my mom's side. My grandma was hard on my dad's side. And she would go to church, but I ain't see a lot of fruit of the Spirit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
My dad, he died as a Christian, but I was 12.
Right.
You know, my brother, he ain't after God. My mom, you know, I got cut. My grandparents, let me see. I had two uncles. They died on my mom's side. One didn't have no kids. My other uncle had three daughters. Needed all three of them. My mom, nieces, they ain't after the Lord. My grandmom on my dad's side, they have five grandkids. I'm one of them. I'm one in the other four. They ain't after God. Like, so I ain't even got my, the perfecting church is my godly family.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I can't even call, you know. So when it says ultimately our children are God, man, God sought me out.
Yeah.
Like that's really, I ain't gonna say I had a praying grandma. You know how some people got that. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that blessed me tremendously. So if he did it for Alexander Speaks, he'll do it for Aubrey, Abraham, Ava. You know, because he found me.
That's what we gotta remind ourselves.
Yeah, he found me. And it's their choice.
That could be tough sometimes. We want our children to we want to go to heaven.
Yeah, we do. We do.
You know what I mean? We want them to live a great life. Yeah. We want them to be successful. But ultimately, we are not in control.
And Dad want to go to heaven too. Because I'm not judging too. But shoot, some of my bedtime prayers are like, Lord, forgive me for any word, deed, action, or thought I did today that wasn't according to your will. I repent in Jesus' name. Good night. Like I just repent. I may wake up and be like, man, it's hot in here. Like, what? It's hot in here, man.
Yeah.
But yeah. So it's just one of those things where you're just like, man.
Yeah. Look. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I'm really excited for what this word has brought to us, man. And I think that we're going to constantly be reminded of who God is and right. reminded what he's capable of, man.
Yeah.
And I think the biggest thing, bro, is he freed us with this.
Yeah.
He freed us with it because now I don't have to take responsibility necessarily for them doing what they're supposed to do, right? After I'm teaching, after right. I get done teaching them.
This is game changing.
After I get
Train
done teaching
up
them.
Up your child in his way.
In his
and
way.
Like, don't even try in to his, put you on.
Right.
Don't put your his sauce
way.
On it.
Right. Yeah. His way.
We've been trying to put our sauce on it. What our yum, it? Yum sauce.
Oh, man, because it's so much out here, man. We, you know, we pick up all these books and personal development yeah. and professional development. And you trying
Let
to teach.
Him have his way all the time.
The word is sovereign, man.
Sovereign control is let me in, invite me to the party, sub me in,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm.
And even if it's quiet, use your faith.
Yeah.
Use your faith.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Man, that's, man.
This was a gut check, yeah, man.
Lord, take over the wheel. We do it typically in emergency.
Yeah.
Nah, man. But I think at the end of the day, you can't be a father until you're connected to the Father.
Right.
Like you really can't. Right. Like he is right. the CEO.
He really is
the landlord. He is the. Like, there's no other way. And I ain't trying to knock no other religion. It's just, yo, it won't work.
Mm.
Mm-mm. Nah.
Mm.
No, it can't work. They're distractions.
Distractions.
Yeah.
I love that boldness.
Yeah, nah.
Love the boldness. Yeah. Yeah.
No, I can't even empathize with your belief. Like, because we're governed. This thing say sovereign. We're under. Like, it's him and it's us. When it say king of kings, we the other kings, but he's the king. Like, if you're not under authority, if you're not hoping for what he is hoping for, you in a hopeless situation.
Mm.
Like, it's no other way.
Wow.
Like, if you're not hoping for what he is hoping for, like, you can't.
Wow.
Nah, you just can't. I don't really have anything else to say. Like, he's sovereign. He's sovereign. He the one that can say, if you fix your lips on someone, that's murder. We can't do that.
Right.
You know? Like, right. he's sovereign.
Right.
You know? He's, yeah.
Wow.
If it's not a faith, it's sin. He the only one that can. He the only one that could put those statues.
Right.
You know, what am I going to give my kids some rules? And like, nah. I mean, I probably can borrow the Ten Commandments, throw them up there. All right, do that. You know? Yeah. But that ain't even mine.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So.
Right. Wow.
Nah, it's just one of those things where you can try. And I'm thankful that he let us share his name. Right. Father.
Right.
I'm a father. You're a father.
Right.
Like,
right.
That's Brandon. Like, how he, Jesus called him Father.
Right.
Like, and he let us use that. We ain't worthy of that, man. Mm. I'm not worthy to be called a father. All the foul stuff I did, but I'm forgiven.
Wow.
You know?
Wow.
Yeah, and I just think when we do certain things, we think we're not qualified or a grace. Nah, man.
Wow.
Man, they had the Jesus play. I think I told you this some time ago about he healed the blind dude and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And that same blind dude was one of the dudes that was crucifying him. And I was like, yo, he just blinded. He changed his mind so I could see now. I was like, so you can really, it's sovereign control.
Wow.
So.
Ultimately, our children of God.
Yeah, yeah. And God is counting on us to be to them like how he is to us.
Right.
Yeah.
Father.
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 Man.
Wow. Man, we can go out on that note. Father. Father.
Well, with that said, guys, make sure y'all go to Spotify, Apple Podcasts, YouTube, Spotify. TikTok, Twitter, Instagram. Follow us. Comment. We would love to hear from you.
Yeah.
There's anything that you want to share in regards to this plan, we would love to hear your thoughts. And with that said.
Yeah, and I want to say something else because a lot of times people, they use certain words. I want to say out of context. And some people can't submit to the Father because of how their natural father is or was. Mm. Let me tell you something. Your natural father can never be greater than that father. So don't use those two words like, oh, when I think of father, I think of my dad. No, no. Don't do that. Don't use that same word. No. Mm-hmm. That's all I'm saying. Some people hear certain words and they triggers.
Yeah.
They're triggers like, no, he is love. He is love. And I know you said, well, if he is love, why did my dad? Sovereign.
Right.
Like sovereignty. Only God is sovereign. Right. God the Father, you know? So, yeah, that's all I wanted to say. Love y'all.
Peace.